At age 21, I wanted to know what God wanted me to do with my life. I was going to school, I was working, but they weren't in areas that I felt like were God's specific will for my life. So I quit everything. I quit school, I quit work, and I just went off for 17 days in the wilderness to spend time with God. I wanted to hear from Him, what did He want me to do with my life? And in that time, I started to look at what are my skills and what are my strengths and what are my gifts and talents and abilities? And what are my inabilities? What am I good at and what am I not good at? You know, what can I change about myself and what do I need to accept about myself? And after 17 days of seeking God and really studying His Word and seeing the ingredients that He planted in me, I sat down and I drew a picture of what I felt like God wanted me to do with my life. And the picture was this ministry. That picture still today hangs in my office as the picture, almost like a baby's picture, of the birth of a new ministry.
We got to stand up today.
It was in 1991 when the vision of the GTD started. It wasn't until 5 years later in 1996 when we did our first event. It was called How Much Can You Shove Into 4 Days? We loaded 20 college students from First Baptist of Indian Rocks into 2 15 passenger vans, and we went up to North Georgia and Tennessee. We went to an Atlanta Braves baseball game. We went to Stone Mountain. We went to Six Flags. We went to Atlanta Fest. We went whitewater rafting. We went rock climbing. We went indoor skydiving. We went bungee jumping. We shoved all this into 4 days, and it was a huge hit. You know, in all that time, we had all these great, exciting activities, and at the heart of it, you know, we kept Jesus first. We sought Him through the reading of His Word. We sought Him through prayer. We sought Him through worship, and it was a great, great time. We were so excited about the first event that I was just so confident that this thing was going to grow into like 40 events the next year. But God had a different growth plan for the ministry, a little bit longer process than I was expecting. The next year, we did one event. In 98, we did two. The following year, we jumped up to 6 events. And then 7 events the next year. 8 events. 2002, we had a breakthrough year. We did 12 events. 03, we did 18 events. In 2004, all the way up to 30 events. And in 2005, 35 events. God has grown the ministry with a momentum that is just from Him.
Well, I get knocked down, but I get up again.
I really don't feel comfortable like talking about the sacrifices that are made, but I want to share these things because when I read through the Bible and I see like these people of God who pursued God and they share with us the sacrifices that they made in order to pursue the passions that God had put on their heart, it's an encouragement to me. And I think it's important that people know that the ministry hasn't just been a bunch of open doors and it hasn't always been, you know, the easy road. In fact, most of the time, it's been one of the hardest things I've ever been a part of, but still the biggest blessing that I've ever been a part of. I've never been injured on any of the events that we provide. I've never been injured by any of the activities that we do. But since the time that the ministry started in 1991, I've been in a head-on collision. I've had a ruptured disc in my back. I've torn my knee ligament. I've broken some ribs. I've dislocated my shoulder. I've torn the tendon that holds my chest in place. I, at one point in my life, had sold everything that was of value of more than $150. I didn't own anything that was of any significant value. My parents have an addition on the back of their house that they've allowed me to live in. And it eventually became my office, the home base for GTD. Okay, if you can imagine, it's this 133 square foot room. And it was where I slept. It's where, you know, I had my little couch. I had, you know, little dugout back in the back. And eventually, as GTD progressed, the couch was removed and a desk was put in. The TV was taken out, another desk was put in. Eventually, my bed was taken out, and I have wall-to-wall desk in there. This is where the home office is for GTD. It's also where I live. And in order for me to still fit in there and reside in my office, I had to take my mattress and cut it in half so that it would fit under my desk. One of the big difficulties we had in the ministry was we went through this time where we just had terrible automobiles. And we had the shuttle. The shuttle became a curse word in GTD because anytime you'd say the shuttle, you'd start remembering all of these terrible things that happened. You know, you'd blow a transmission, or you had flat tires, or the alternator stopped working, or the old retro van that we had, we'd be on the side of the road sometimes with a radiator that's blown, or another transmission. We went 3 years in a row where we had transmissions blowing in three different vehicles. And so you just have to learn to roll with the punches. That a lot of times these things happen, and you just have to make the best of a bad situation. And we do that in GTD, and that's one of the things I love about this ministry. No matter how bad the circumstances are, and I think that's the thing God wants to constantly teach us, is that He's the God who is bigger than our circumstances. And every one of the events that we go on, we end up pulling these things off, and they end up being an incredible time. And the very difficulties that were the hard things in the moment become the things that we talk about and are the highlights weeks later. So God uses difficulties a lot of times, not only to build our character, but to build memories and to build camaraderie. Thanks God from whom I praise Him, praise Him, all creatures. One of the most encouraging things about being a part of this ministry is to experience this awesome support system that God's put around me. These incredible parents that supply me not only with the best meals I've ever had and a roof over my head, but nonstop encouragement ever since this ministry started. The sister that I've got, who supports me like the best fan a person could ever have, cheering me on from the side. A best friend that I've grown up with for my entire life, who not only has been there to encourage the ministry, but has jumped in completely to be a part of the ministry and to work with me and to make the sacrifices as well. God's put all these friends around me that just constantly encourage and support the ministry. Never have I heard a negative word. Never have I heard, man, why are you doing this? It's always just a word of blessing and encouragement. God's put volunteers in the ministry, people who show up to help guide trips, to help coordinate different components of the ministry, to help direct different programs. And one of the biggest blessings is to find out as you're pursuing your own dream is that ministry isn't an individual sport. It's a team sport. And God supplies all these people along the way to help accomplish something that's going to glorify His name. God puts ministry partners into our ministry to help financially support us. He puts it on people's hearts to donate to the ministry so that we can accomplish these things. At the very heart of it, all of these things are a result of how good God is and how much God has blessed this ministry and put His whole hand of endorsement on it. It's an exciting thing, and I love it. What's unique about GTD is that it's founded on putting God first. So if you do all these adventure things, but you don't have God, you've got a bunch of empty, hollow actions. But when you include God in the midst of the pursuit of the adventure, in the midst of the pursuit of the fun, you have a complete experience that not only causes you to grow closer to God, it causes you to fall more in love with God. So at the very heart of it, we like to have fun. We want to love man, but ultimately, we want to glorify God.
What I think I've learned so much this week is how important it is to have, just other people you can just have fun and worship with. And because, I mean, I'm used to being, a loner, the only one wanting to, actually do something, fun and exciting and be a Christian at the same time and things like that. And this is so awesome to see, so many people just so sold out for Christ. And, I mean, the leaders, you guys are so awesome. Go crazy over things, and I love that.